It's one thing when you're like working with a group of people on the internet and you're trying to make like an open source 3D thing. It feels very familiar and hobbyist level. And then it's another thing when now suddenly on the phone with the hospitals and the doctors and you're hearing about the real cases. This is how many ventilators we have. This is how much time we have before we're at capacity. How fast can you make something? And now, like, talk about lighting a fire under your ass. Like, here we go, man.
The American Hospital Association was suggesting that our entire hospital system in the United States may only have as many as 63,000 functional ventilators. And worst case scenario, we may need as many as 900,000. Because the truth is the virus is spreading very, very quickly and it's inconsiderate of borders. It's happening to every country, to every person is being impacted by this all around the world. So you need a worldwide solution.
What I did is I set it up with two very good friends of mine, Conal Laverty and David Pollard. The joke is we set up an enterprise scale organization made fully of volunteers spread remotely around the world. The designs were freely shared and iterated. Our goal was to create an open source ventilator.
And it is exploding. It started a week ago, and already we've organized 1,000 different volunteers, engineers, designers, medical professionals all across the globe. And just keeping things organized is an incredibly difficult task. And I'm just trying to do it for the US.
Public channels, phew, private, phew.
I put a brick down, and then the wall just follows. So basically, we have a million makers.
The Get will have specific approvers in each area.
In terms of hardware and electronics direction, I need something to give this team.
That's the system circuit.
Okay. Do we have to monitor temperature and humidity?
We need tidal volume, respiratory rate, intake, yeah, exhale ratio, plateau airway pressure, driving pressure, and PEEP.
We had the idea to like just put out a more detailed survey form that would capture people's skill sets, their interests, their experience. So that's how we picked the team to work on the Altium project for putting together these electronics. But also the development team, regardless of where they were all working off the same design, version control. The team in West Michigan was able to go from design files to built prototype in less than 24 hours. Even volunteers from my competitors are now on our internal server here working on this project. So in times like this, we get to kind of like set all that other stuff aside. Really, as humans, we can attack this problem. There are tons of OSV electronics teams. We're one of them.
Made ventilators from Home Depot. And more interesting is kind of like a suitcase that opens up.
We have at least two respiratory therapists on the line.
How much total pressure does the machine need to be able to deliver?
PEEP needs to be adjustable from anywhere from probably 0 to maybe 20.
It is a real intermingling of worlds, both age, location, skill level, and then expertise. You know, these were ragtag bunches of self-assembled people scattered around the world, sitting at the main table with World Health Organizations, like large government bodies and large Fortune 100 companies.
Now you're participating with Ford and Detroit, yeah, right in your own backyard.
The prediction was that we were 5 to 10 days away from hitting capacity on ventilators. What Google Sheets has done for sharing the specifications and the documents, Altium and Concord has made possible on the design side. People could get to that single source of truth for all the design information. They were able to collaborate with each other, and that has been critical to the reason that we were able to get this far this fast. You can cut this out extremely fast. Like, this side panel takes 38 seconds to make. The other thing is, once it's all together, it is very, very easy to go through and sanitize all the different touch points. And we're going to be working with Chris Denny over at Worthington Assembly.
I said, hey, how can I help? I'm a manufacturer, you know, I'm an executive at this company and I have resources and machines. What can I do to give you guys a hand?
Even with materials and machine time and assembly, you can put one of these together for a couple $100. Sticker price on a new ventilator is typically between $25,000 and $50,000. Design is just about ready. We're going to build them. All the hard work is paying off and it's becoming tangible and it's becoming usable. Yes! So awesome. Here's our multi-board electronics assembly. a ground up design developed by the global and local open source ventilator team. And then Monday we're sending these off to get made, and Calumet Electronics offered to make a couple panels for us. And now it's just finding a manufacturer and figuring out what it takes to get through FDA and all these other steps we have to do to make it available in the US. This is class 2 FDA life support equipment. And there's a lot of regulations you have to go through. And the consultants we were talking to today told us, they're like, yeah, we're seeing all these ventilator designs come out, but we just know they're never going to be able to be used. This project, they said, was the first one they'd seen that actually looked viable and that they could see like really using in a hospital setting. We went from an idea to an organization to an engineering team to 4 physical prototypes, now to a validated, distributed, multi-board system that's going to keep people alive, all in 4 weeks. When people do this and they just kind of put the bullshit aside and get organized and get focused, and you pull out all the limits that humans self-impose, when you remove that and you come together, it's completely unstoppable.
We are the decentralized special forces of design, and we operate at a higher level than most task forces at the moment.
Like a designer needs a CAD tool, we engineer together. You can't have the other without the one. So get out of your pajamas and open your laptops. Engineering's essential. Let's get the work done.
Because I've run think tanks and we've run tons of brainstorming exercises together. There's nothing like this kind of jazz music. So that's the end of the story, really.
I don't think that the engineering community has ever been more connected. That's what gives me hope. Building that sense of community is what the world needs right now. It's incredible what can happen when everyone comes together.
Like a layout needs a schematic, we engineer together. You can't have the other without the one. Stick figures look simple, but they hold all the data. Layouts need schematics, let's get the work done.
This was the very first prototype. The idea was that the bag sits right in here. There's a belt that goes on to the spool, and all that happens is the belt.
Like transmission lines need return paths, we engineer together. You can't have the other without the one. So back up your signals with unbroken reference planes. SI is important, let's get the work done.
This is the second prototype we had, a little bit more sophisticated, a little bit. And the idea here is there's a roller that comes through and compresses the bag this way. And there was a cam mechanism in here that didn't quite work out right.
Like a fab shop needs data, we engineer together. You can't have the other without the one. So run your design checks, list all your fab specs, release all the drawings, make the processes run.
Concept 3, we really kicked it into gear. We have the arms here that clamp the bag itself, but with it just being the thin arm, there we weren't getting a lot of engagement on the bag, and we weren't getting the right amount of volume.
Like a project needs stakeholders, we're engineered together. You can't have the other without the one. Engineering, procurement, manufacturing, test and shipping, we all work together to get the boards done.
Used to having a 2,000 square foot workshop. I've condensed all that down to my dining room table here. Please forgive the mess, it's all hot off the press.